Hello, dear friends, how are you? So today, we on verse 16 on the article called Gift of the Bible, Matan Torah. And we're finishing the article today, so it's very exciting. Let's read. Rabbi Ashlag says here that the Torah wasn't given to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, even though God could give the Torah to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, but God decided to give the Torah only a few hundred years after to the children of the children of the children of the children of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob on Mount Sinai. Only 400 years after. Then there was a nation of 600,000 people. And God asked each and every one of them on Mount Sinai, are you willing to accept upon yourself this great spiritual work called caring for others, loving others, sharing, influencing light, filling the world with light, filling the world with the energy, with the light of love of the Creator? Are you willing to take upon yourself? Every person on Mount Sinai, that was the question. And every one of them said, it's all of us. All of us were there on Mount Sinai. We all said, yes, God. We will do everything to reveal your light in the world, to reveal the light of love through caring for other people, through sincere care, through sincere love, unconditional love. We're going to reveal your light in the world. And God says, okay, now I can give you the Torah. Because when we're talking about, just Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, if God would give him the Torah and say, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, I'm sending you from a spiritual mission to teach the world about loving. They would do it. They actually did it, but it wasn't enough. The Torah is a tool, the channeling the light of love. So God waited for a huge amount of people, 600,000, which is kind of a critical mass of souls that say, yes, we will do everything to inspire the world about connecting to the light force of God. We will do everything in order to inspire the world to love each other, to care for each other, by understanding that if you're caring for that human being, that's how you're connecting to God, by becoming like Him. So when a huge amount of people said, yes, that's our mission, God says, now I can start to reveal my light in the world. Now I can bring the Torah to this world. Now people can use the light of the Torah, which is the light of love, in order to fill the world with the light of love. Now the game actually starts. Because when you have so many people, their mission is to care for everyone else. So you don't have so many worries. Why we have so many worries? Because we're afraid no one will take care of us. We are alone in this world. I'm not going to take care of myself. No one will. But if you see so many people around you, that everyone running all their life just to care for others, you also become like that. You say, oh, I see that they're running to care for others. And whatever they need in their life, they have. Why? Because that's the magic. That if you care for others, God will take care of you. Whatever you need will be there. So you say, oh, I can also live like that. I see that everyone around me living their life with that consciousness. I just care for everyone and everything that I need. It's okay to take care of yourself. Means obviously you need to go buy food, make money, take care of your kids, of course. But are you always just worrying about yourself? Or is your main concern in caring for the world? Take care of whatever you need to take care, yes. But sometimes we can fall to the trap of all day long just taking care of myself. It's a big trap. Because we came to this world to reveal the light of love. It means take care of yourself, and now go ahead and care for others and for the world. Don't just stay with me and me and me and me and me, you know? So when you see that more and more people behaving like that, they're pushing their energy, their life, the main concern is others, you feel comfortable also to behave like that. You feel comfortable because everyone around you behave like that, so you want to be like that as well, because you also see that if you live that way of life, everything eventually, you know, whatever you need will appear in your life. So you know, you don't have all those fears and worries of, if I'll just take care of everyone, who will take care of me? You suddenly see that it can work. You can actually take care of everyone and things will be fine in your life. Wow, you can actually live that way. Not just that, things will be even better than if you'll all day long just take care of yourself. So it's a great system how to have it all. By constantly caring for everyone, you're becoming like God, you're connecting to God, everything that you need will come to your life, which will be much even better than if you all day long will take care of yourself. Much, much better. That's why, you know, we have a privilege. And today, especially today, each and every one of us, we are sparks of the 600,000 souls that came to reveal the light of love in the world. We are sparks of those souls. And if we're taking upon ourselves, when we say to God, in Hebrew we call it Na'aseh V'Nishma, we will do everything that you'll tell us, God, and we will listen to everything that you're telling us. We will do. Everything that you'll tell us, we'll do, God. And we will listen. Means what? We want to be your channels, God. We don't just want to do what we want, to say what we want to say. We want to be channels for your light. The light of love, the light of God is the light of God, of love. God, we want to be channels for your light. It means that my concern and my energy and my focus, God, send me. Where can I reveal your light of love in the world? Where do you need me? What do you need me to do today? What do you need me? Where do you want me? Where do you need me to reveal your light, to reveal the light of love? If you sincerely want to do what God wants you to do in order to reveal the light of love in the world, you'll start to be His messenger. You'll meet the people, or you'll be in the certain situations that you can reveal the light of love by expressing love, by caring for the other human being, by listening to the other human being, by teaching and educating the other person how to lift themselves, how to connect to the Creator, how to open their heart. You'll be a channel of light, channel of love. But it need to be that you'll say, that's what I want. God, that's what I want to be. I want to be your channel to reveal your light, light of love to the world. Once you're saying it, once you're taking it upon yourself, you start to be the channel of God. And you start to reveal light in the world. And you start to push away darkness from the world. Starting to make a difference. Starting to give joy to the Creator through your actions. Joy to your own soul. And you're becoming closer and closer to God. So we finished today the article called Matan Torah, Gift of the Bible, which is a great celebration. And we're going to continue. We're going to continue another article next time called Arvut. It means mutual responsibility for each other. Stay with us. It's very important articles, very important information that can help us to, in a precise way, understand what's the mission here in this world. What is it that God wants from us? How to reveal His light in the world in a very precise way. And that's why it's so important to actually learn directly from the book of Rabbi Ashlag, gift of the Bible, to get the message in the most accurate way, so we can do the work in the best way possible. Thank you, everyone. Blessings to all.